own performance analysis. So we got data from different places, like the cities, state DOT. We have real-time data, or like the offline data, like the incident and accident data. We also have the sensors deployed there, but the sensor has the GPS. We can always send back information, and we can visualize that in our network. And the design we follow, the relay, the so-called fat server and simpline design, we use everything free. And I mentioned this is the e-science platform because we make this computationally very heavy. So researchers may escape all the troubles to organize the data, clean the data. They just need to work on the computational layer, make use of the data. So that efficiency would be a lot better. And another advantage of this kind of design is really when you need to transfer this to the cloud, it's a very easy way to transfer. And a lot of the security control work could be done in the server. So at the terminal end, like when a user have a phone to access it, you don't need to consume any resource on your terminal device. So these are all the advantages for this system. So we build a bunch of things like for decision support. For example, this is a level of service map. You know, highway capacity manual really offers like a level of services. If on the pathway, it's relatively complicated, right? Grab the geometric information, gather count data, convert the vehicles into passenger cars, and also looking at the slope, whatever. So now, if you click the button, this will give you the whole network in a couple seconds. So you can look at what time you want to see the level of service, right? If you integrate the level of services, for example, you have a big transportation construction project, you can compare before and after. In the peak hour, what's the improvement? Off-peak hour, what's the improvement? So this tool will offer that kind of analysis capability, and is pretty straightforward and easy. Washington State DOT also needs to report their roadway performance, and they have predefined corridors, and there are also corridors they want to select, like as the customized corridors. They used to have some research engineers to work on this subject. Multiple people work for multiple months to get such charts done. And depends on who is looking at the data, how they control the data, the results may be different. But this one, you click the button, and the system automatically cleans the data and pulls the data for analysis. So this could be done in seconds. So the efficiency and the consistency is a lot better. So how would the traffic affect the environment, right? We also paid a test the corridor, try to see emissions. And this is actually the emission control map. You can see at what time and which milepost location you see more pollutants of any kind that's been created in the system. Safety analysis. So this is system-wide rather than a particular location. So we can see these are the observed ones, and we can use the model to see actually what are the expected number of accidents. And you can also use different models. This is the model based on the highway safety manual approach. But if you have a better model, you can try to replace with your own model. If it's good, you can save it, and people can use it later. Right? So this is the function we're still working on. And travel time reliability. People now try to give up like the density-based measure and try to use the reliability-based measures instead. And this is the function we built. For example, you can choose your start time, and you can choose, show me the 95 reliability, like 80% reliability, etc. And then within 15 minutes period, starting from here, how far I can travel. So the green one is the 95% reliability bridge. And the yellow one is the 80%, and the orange one 65%, and your customized one could be the blue one, right? So this one you can see the reliability given the time frame and the route you selected. So anyway, so we see a lot of data now available. So this is actually the work we're working with Tsinghua University using the GPS navigation system data. So these are actually the five ring roads in Beijing. You see how this looks like. So this is the fifth ring road, and the ring road at any given location. So the word provides the time changes. So if you want to make a decision and try to control part of the road to make smooth the traffic, make the traffic run better. I think you can look at this and make your right decision. So anyway, so this is a lot of things that I can talk to you, but given the time constraint, I will stop here and open for questions.
Thank you very much.
Four minutes for questions, please. I do actually have a question. Okay,
sure.
So there's a saying that if you want to start flossing your teeth, you should start by flossing one tooth. So what is the one tooth that cities should start flossing? What's the one thing that cities can do now to start integrating big data so that it can be used by researchers?
I think, first of all, the right mindset, right? They really value the data. A lot of cities, they want to keep data for 3 months and then dump it.
Okay.
Yeah, if they keep doing that, they will not data accumulated to make a historical discovery. So I keep telling them, you know, all people provide the data for us because it's in our system. And we can offer a lot of benefit for you as all of you. So I think, let's say you ask a city traffic engineer, how many congestions about your neural network, are they independent or correlated? When they occur, they cannot tell you. But if you look at our system, looking at like a traffic flow map, every minute, right? You can see from all green when the first yellow point show up and then the red point. Do they show up all the time? So this kind of discovery is much, much more efficient than if you have somebody looking at the 10,000 loop detector data, try to see where is this loop. So I think the thing to have the right mindset is the first tool they should cross.
Okay. If this like data big component here. So where can we get this data? Are there readily available data sets that you know of? Like, privacy seems like an issue, so how do you get to this data? And are there easy ways to do that?
I think every state usually has a bunch of data, but not all the data is organized and placed into the right platform. For example, Federal Highway released them. We call it here data set, but they have a long name now. It's basically based on the Nokia phone, cell phone, like GPS data. So we have a lot of data. But this data stays in the separate data set, not really integrated. To integrate these things is really challenging because the here data set use a different TMC code. And here is data, different TMC code, and Russia data has another one. So simply putting these things together require the research effort, and that's why I listed three emerging research directions. I think one, the first one matters. Without that, all the individual data set cannot be mingled.
I know you raised hand for a while, so how are you?
I saw in the system architecture that you have already integrated some sources of data. So my question is, have you done some consultancy services for some city or maybe local government with the data that you already have available so you can support the decisions and some projects?
Yeah, I think our platform collects data from state and city agencies. And the purpose is serving them. We have a watchdog version. The first phase research community, we deliver two functions. One is the level service analysis, another is actually supporting their congestion report functioning. So we are working on the Facebook. So other cities, they don't have the research fund, but clearly they may see some of these functions useful.
So how about last question? Carrie, I want to ask the last question.
It's okay. I can ask
that. So with that, please join me. Thank you again for the next class, they are waiting.